Also jetzt alle hier drei Kollegen und immer mit der FH, der auch mich heisst.
Zum Essen und Beraten, oder? Wir haben permis, dass Preau prezentarea următorilor doi invitați, să vorbesc scenă, să mă dau așa. Să citesc cu sprijinul Biz, asta e. Să le mulțumesc celor de la Biz, scuze, n-am făcut la început, eram emoționat, nu prezint prea multe conferințe. Claudia spune să menționez și partenerii mei de Iuluțe pe linia de la Pârvu, le mulțumesc. Ok, am trecut și peste momentul ăsta. Vreau să vă spun câteva lucruri despre următorii doi speakeri. E vorba de Virgil și de Patricia. Sunt două doamne foarte simpatice care lucrează la Vitra, un lider mondial la capitolul mobilier pentru birou și nu numai. Este o companie de familie și asta contează destul de mult. Ce încearcă cumva să schimbe percepțiile și să schimbe felul în care arată spațiile de birou. Ei investesc foarte mult în tot ce înseamnă cultura de design. Dacă unii dintre voi poate ați auzit de ansamblu arhitectural din Wallenrain, în Germania, unde sunt niște clădiri extrem de spectaculoase, Vitra are și un muzeu de design. Și vă invit să descoperiți, dacă ați făcut-o deja, pe site-ul vitra.com mai mult despre această companie. Unele lucruri se vor regăsi și în cele două prezentări. O să încep cu Pirio. Pirio este arhitect și lucrează foarte mult cu clienți mari. Unde lucrurile sunt destul de complexe, pentru că vorbim de proiecte de foarte mare amploare, de multe ori vorbim de clădiri întregi, vorbim de diferite reprezentanțe diverse țări și peste tot conceptul inițial trebuie să se regăsească într-un mod cât mai autentic. Mai mult o să vă las pe birou să vă povestească despre ceea ce poate însemna biroul unor cetățeni, unor oameni care interacționează și lucrează bine împreună. Birou, please.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Hello. Thanks for the introduction. And sorry for my not existing Romanian. I have to speak English. It's not my mother language either, and I had a great evening with Claudia and Mihai, so I hope you can understand me, otherwise give me a sign. I could not really understand what Stefan and Cosmin said, but from Stefan I saw the pictures showing how spaces can express the CI or the understanding of the company very well, so it's great now also for my speech. And Cosmin, because of you, I could skip one third of my speech, but I have more pictures than you, so I would like to show it to them, to you anyway. Okay, who knows Vitra? Good. Wow. Okay, so you might know us from the drawings, of course, the chairs. We have some iconic chairs. You see them quite frequently also in TV shows. And maybe you have seen one of our shows from the museum. They're traveling around the world. Or some of you might have been in Weil am Rhein at our campus and have seen the great campus with all these nice buildings of very well-known architects. So myself, I'm from the interior design team of Vitra. I'm interior architect, and we are dealing with a lot of clients doing space planning, as you might know it, as architects with our furniture, of course. Maybe you don't know yet that we have also a lighting company, Belux, so we also think about the lighting in this space, and we do, like interior architects do, the whole interiors with materials and colors, etc. And we always care to think to the last accessories, like you see here, it's amazing. It's really well done. So that's my job at Vitra. But it's more, like Mr. Fehlbaum said, our owner, when you think about offices, it's much more than interior design and doing nice spaces. It's also which business model you have, your HR has to fit, the management. So all this together in the end gives a perfect office. My speech will start I will zoom out and look from above what is happening in the world, because then we can understand what happens to us as an employee and how we have to deal with it. Then I would like to give a short introduction into the history of the Citizen Office. I would like to point out the advantages you have with the Citizen Office, and in the end I would like to show you some references of clients who helped to find their Citizen Office. So I start with the influences, and as we all know, the world becomes quite small thanks to all the digital little tools we have. So our working life becomes much more complex because we have a really high pace. We work very fast, much more complex because we have to deal with a lot of different people during our job, and we have to deal with a lot of nationalities thanks to globalization. So of course this is influencing a lot our understanding or our work life. It's not anymore that we do like in Taylorism, we do every day the same job. It's every hour, it's a different challenge we have. And thanks to all the nice devices we have, and also the fast internet and the clouds, I mean, we can work from everywhere, wherever we are. Our sales, they experience every day. But in the end, it's nice to be somewhere else, but in the end, whoever experienced home office, is there anybody who did home office for a longer period? Yeah. I did it myself and I experienced I could work for any company, I'm not attached anymore, and I miss the social contact with my colleagues, so I feel really, it doesn't matter anymore what I'm doing. So for us it's really important, and we believe that the office will not die. There will always be a space for a company, because just here I quite like the image. You can feel the pace of a company, there is somebody who gives direction, you can feel the spirit, and of course it's teamwork, because if one is not growing in the same pace, it's a problem. So it's really important to have this office to bring also together all the nationalities. Diversity is a big issue. We have different nationalities, like for example at Google in Zurich, they have 700 employees out of 60 nations, you can imagine. It's like the Tower of Babylon. But it also is that more and more women are going into the working world, so that's also an issue. And the other part is people, especially in Germany, we work until we are 67. So there are only the old employees and the younger ones coming in. So it's all about diversity in the office. And the office has to give a marketplace for all of them to be able to build a common knowledge, and also to help them to exchange ideas. So this will always be the task of the office. And as I don't know in Romania, I tried to find some figures, but in Germany we call it a war for talents. We have tough times to find good people. So the employee in fact becomes much more valuable. And I think the younger generation in Germany, they could feel already they can pick their jobs. My generation, we were happy when we got whatever job, but now they are able to choose. So as a company, of course, you have to set some signs that you find good employees and that you inspire them. Every second year there's the Gallup study, and every second year since 8 years, I look at it, it's the same figures. 87% of the employees are just doing their job. And that's quite scary when you think about your own company, maybe. You have 15%, they are really committed and they are pushing things forward. And you have 61, they come in the morning at 8 and they leave at 5, they do their job, but they are not really engaged. And 24%, they are already lost because they already left the company in their minds. So what would be really helpful for each company to bring some of the 61% into the committed, on the committed side. You can imagine then it's a business case, yeah, then the company is winning. And when you look at what is motivating people, it has changed from the 80s. In the 80s, money was really important, a car was really important, but nowadays it's also important to have a good working atmosphere. And again, this is about management, about HR, but also, as we believe, the space is influencing people, it's about the space. And you can imagine, really a valuable, intelligent person will not be really motivated going there every day. So this is not the kind of open space we are talking about. The citizen office is not this. So, but still in Germany, 90% of our clients, when I go there and look around, it looks like that. And really scary is that one person doesn't know who's sitting two offices further, so they don't know each other, they can't exchange ideas. It's not working, it's not a nice atmosphere. But also this is an example of a magazine in Germany which is talking about good office spaces. But that's not the idea we have in mind when we talk about citizen office. Because as you can see, for example, here, they don't really have informal communication spaces. They are just sitting close to each other. Interior-wise, it's just you have the impression they are stuffed in. There's no real rhythm in the space. So that's not the idea either. I would like to take you now to Germany, to Weil am Rhein, to our campus. And in one of the buildings from Grimshaw, there's our idea of the perfect office, the Vitra office. And this office is, it was planned as a factory, so we have the advantage to have 2,000 square meter almost without pillars. And this was, I can never believe that was Vitra before. But 98, our office really looked like that. So on 2,000 square meter, there were sitting 69 employees in cubicles. Because that time, we were dealers for Herman Miller, and this system is called Action Office, so we used it in our office. But it was impossible to find somebody. You couldn't see anybody. Communication was dead. The only thing you could really see were the plants, and the ceiling was quite expressive. So we found 98, it's time for a change. And Rolf Fehlbaum thought back, it's time for a change, because of course the space is influencing the mind of people. So Rolf Fehlbaum was reminding himself of a workshop we had in 93 with three famous Italian architects, Sozzas, De Lucchi and Brandi. And they were thinking about the office of the future, and they had Siemens together. They were talking about the newest technology. And they had in their mind an office should be like a landscape or a city. So every citizen is able to find a spot for the work he has to do, and also the mood he is in, because it's quite important. Some days are quite, you are open, you want to talk to people, but you have days you don't want to talk to too many people, so you have to have your privacy too. So it's like a landscape, you can find always the right spot. And they were also, of course, thinking about furniture, like Sozzas, he invented movable furniture, it's like the nomad office, because he was thinking, okay, people are traveling more and more, and they have different tasks to do, so they want to move around. And De Lucchi was already thinking about a homely office, so it should be almost like back home, where you can find also sofas and armchairs and feel really relaxed. And Franzi was thinking about the vertical office, because he was thinking about all this technology you have to deal with, printers and computers, etc. So out of this idea, Mr. Fehlbaum contacted Sarah Peach, an interior architect from London, and she started 98 to design our office new. And it's called New Office. It was then in the year 2000, and you see the change already. It's much more friendly and open. and in reality to really broke down the walls, and not only physically but also mentally, because you can imagine coming into this open space, communication is starting immediately, you see your colleagues, you want to share things, and we also had like retreat areas with this build out, so it was quite a big change for us. And of course, out of this idea of the vertical office, we had also a system called Monowall, but we soon realized that the walls again are breaking the communication. So the next step was to take that out, and we had contact with really young designers, the Boulet brothers, and their concept or their idea of an office was it's like in the kitchen of your grandma, where everybody is sitting around the table, grandma is baking, and the children are doing their homework. So here it's the connection and the communication again, and they invented this table called Join. So that's really a table for teamwork, for exchanging ideas quite fast. But then in you realized communication is not everything. So like Cosmin said before, you also have to have some spaces where you can take yourself out of this big community, where you can have your privacy, where you can have an informal chat with your colleague and not everybody's listening to it. So the next step we had in our office was the net and nest idea. Netting means communicating, of course you need it, this will never be lost. But what is new is the nesting idea. So you still have spaces where you can take yourself out and hide a bit. And then the last change was 2011. This is now the citizen office. And we much more increased the spaces for retreat. So there's a lot of spaces for meet and communication. But now it's even more for retreat, like you see in the background, the two boxes. You can go there alone or with a group of people, but you in fact step out of the common area. The citizen office, that time when we changed it, we did it like we do it with our clients, because to do a great floor plan, you have to understand the company. So when we started to change, we asked our colleagues, how their working relations are, who has to sit close to whom, what do they need in their surroundings. And we found, so that's the floor plan, it's really great, it's like 70 by 30 meters, it's a big playground. And we have two workstation areas, they are quite dense. In the front, on the right side, you have all the teams they are working for the production. And on the left side, you have all teams working with the sales. So they have to sit really close together to get information quite fast. But in the center, it's called the office forum, you have plenty of space for informal meetings or formal meetings or retreat and relaxation. So you can see one third of the space is just for communication and retreat. I would like to show you now a day in our office. This is now the space of the interior design team. This is my team. And as we are constantly together with clients and traveling a lot, we have this huge desk where when we are in the office, we meet and we can talk very easy. And also as we have big plans, we need a big table to spread out the plans. But very close by, you see in the background the box, if you have enough of all that talking, we can just hide away in the box. And this is quite essential that you have these kind of possibilities very close to your working space. So it's not hot desking, so everybody knows that's my home base, but still I have the possibilities to walk around. This is now an area, it's a temporary workstation. The girl just sitting here in front, and this is very close to the corridor because, for example, there are sitting people from other ITRA offices. They just come for 1 or 2 hours and they want to sit very close to the corridor, to the traffic area, to see people, because then they want to connect. And they can say, ah, stop, I have a question. They don't need to write so many emails, they can just do it face to face. And that's now a view into the office forum. and here you see all the different possibilities of meetings. You can go really exposed on the sofa and having a chat with your colleague, or you can use the team table, the project table in the background when you need a desk to work on. Or if you want to have more privacy, you use the alcove, the sofas here. And what is also quite important in this kind of offices, that you have double functions, because then you save also space. Like what you see left is our cafeteria, but it's also used as meeting space, so you use the space really efficient. And the last one, that's also very important, to change position. You cannot always work on your desk as a normal position. High work is quite functional because you can spread out your documents, and also you can decide how the meeting should be. You can imagine when you have a stand-up meeting, it's quite quicker and you can solve problems fast. But when you would like to do a brainstorm, maybe you pick a sofa, because then you sit more comfortable and your brain is working in a different way. So it's also very important to have a lot of different possibilities for communication. And the last now is my favorite one. It's the little courtyard we have. And in summertime it's amazing, because thanks to technology we have a Wi-Fi there too, and we can work outside. And yeah, you then really feel like on the terrace back home. So that's a little view into our space in Weil am Rhein. And what is really important, this is our solution. It's not the solution for everybody here. So we help to understand, or we help that the client understands their needs. It's really an image of the organization, and it has to fit into the space. So you have first to understand the organization, and then you can think about a floor plan. And of course you need the technology, because you can imagine without Wi-Fi or mobile phones, you can't use it as you should use it. And in the end, when we talk to clients, it's also a business case, because our argumentation is, this is an average of what a company expends per year in Germany. 80% is the labor cost, it's huge, and only 2% is furnishing cost. So if you can do the furnishing as good, so you push the 80%, or you motivate the 80% of your employees, you have a win-win situation. And even clients like banks understand the logic behind. So use the chances. Where are the advantages of a citizen office? I would like to resume. Of course, it's cost reduction, because you use the space more efficient, you can save some space, but it's not about density. Yeah? Open space is not just you want to save space, you will save space, but that's not the only purpose it has. It has to be really quality inside the space. But it's an easy, it's like mathematics. I mean, if you think about when you compare cellular office, a layout of a cellular office, for one desk you need so much corridor space, because you have the main corridor, and you have inside the rooms, you have another corridor to get to the desk. So adding this up, you lose a lot of space for just one person. And there's no more place for communication areas, etc. You can win already space if you think about combi offices. You reduce the space for the offices itself, and you win some space in the center. And here you see it's the same layout, but you bring in already one more person, and you have four more touchdown spaces, and you have much more communication space. So that's already more efficient. And when we look now into a citizen office layout, it becomes even more efficient, because then suddenly you win six more places and two touchdowns. And it looks more dense, but in the same time you have much more possibilities to escape the density. And I think these are quite striking figures for everybody thinking about a new office space. What we often have in our workshop with clients, that suddenly they don't need that much space anymore, and they skip. So So it's not so nice for the real estate agent. And the second possibility is of course the idea of keeping your employees, finding good employees. Many companies close in Germany, they are at the countryside, so it's very nice to go there for holidays, but they can't find real employees. So they try to have good architecture, an attractive office to attract them. And you can imagine having or coming to a company like this, you would like to work. And of course, like I said before, the different generations have to find their place. Like Generation Y, they are used to constantly talk and they are used to interconnect a lot. But baby boomers, for example, they need much more space to retreat. So you have to find the right balance in your company to offer them a marketplace where they can exchange their ideas. And the third is, like Stefan already said, the corporate culture, the branding. You can do a lot with interior architecture to express your culture and to give an idea to the clients, but also to the employees, who you are and what you want to be. Like this, for example, what do you think what it is? What kind of company? You have any idea? But it's not. These are scientists from the ETH Zurich. And they have chosen this kind of design because they want to attract the young talents and they want to really push the market. So that's why they wanted to have bright colors and a really cozy atmosphere. And last but not least, of course, you are interested that your staff is working really efficient and motivated. And one part is the health, the ergonomics. And as you are constantly walking around in a citizen office, you can change your position from desk height to stand-up height. You can sit in the sofa. It's very good for your ergonomics. But also what I experience, if you change viewpoint, like you are not 8 hours sitting at the same place, but you change, you walk somewhere, you always get a better idea, you always get new ideas. It's like going to get a coffee. By walking there, I could do it like this. So it helps much more to keep your mind fit. And there's also a study, it's quite interesting if you want to check it. It's Office 21 called, it's from the Fraunhofer Institute. And also like every year or every second year, they have this check with different companies and different offices. And the two-person's office has a bad performance and also it's bad for motivation. Two-person's offices in Germany is standard before we come. But when you think about it, if you don't like the other person in front of you, it's a nightmare. You don't want to go there anymore. So, of course, the single office is great for concentration, but you are cut off of the rest. So in the end, the mixed office format is the best to motivate people and also the best for the performance because you can fast exchange, but you can also find your quiet spot where you are by yourself. Of course, when clients come to us and they have to think about an open space office, they are very scared, especially about the noise. So if you plan an open space, we always ask for specialists for acoustics because especially the ceiling, we have to be careful, it has to be absorbing. The walls should be absorbing, like you see it here. And also the furniture can help a lot. And also how you position things in the floor plan. Like in the background you have the quiet zone, in the front you have the loud zones. So that's really very important when you start planning. And also what I think personally is really important, the lighting. Because when you think open space, you have a big space. And if you have the same lighting throughout, you become really tired and your brain isn't working anymore. So we need to define the workplace lighting and the atmospheric lighting. You can point out the architecture with lighting. So the lighting design for an open space is essential, like you see here. Of course, you need your task light. here the indirect lighting, and you can switch on also your task light direct at your place. But then for all the communication areas, you have the atmospheric lighting. And this is then like you have it outside with clouds and sun. It keeps you fit, your mind fit. And in the end, it's about colors and materials, because that's what we have constantly around us, what we see and what we feel. So it's also very important to find the right materials and colors to point out the individuality of each one. Okay, in the end, I show you the same four references. First of all, it's SAP in Waldorf. It's a huge company, and you might think everybody wants to work there, but they have the same problem. They need to find really the best talents and good workers, and they wanted to set an example of the perfect office. So they came to us, and we supported them with an analysis of the space. That's the one of their floor plans, and the orange areas is the standard working areas, but in the center, at the core, we created like meeting spaces and teamwork spaces and retreat spaces, because they are working according to Scrum method. Do you know the Scrum idea? It's a method to fasten up creative processes. So there are like stand-up meetings every Monday, there are pair programming phases, and the office has to support those processes. And here you have the look into the stand-up office, where the workplaces are. And here on the left you see where the pair programming, always two people are programming at the same time, so they have little booths where they can take them out a little bit of the common office. And you see on the right side is meeting space and sofa areas, and they have also a billiard room. This was designed by Scope Interior Architects, so there we only did the analysis. And the next example is a digital agency, Razorfish, in Frankfurt. And here we came to the existing office, it looked like this. Was quite nicely designed, nice views, but really heavy furniture. And as in a digital agency, you constantly change the teams, because you pitch for this project and you work on this project, so the team sizes are changing, the people working there are changing. So we found out in the workshop how they work together and what are their needs. And so the boss of Razorfish said, I want to have the agile office. And we were really scared, because we thought, oh my god, the furniture is moving, the walls are moving, the people are moving, it will be a big mess, so how can we control it? And we thought about, okay, we bring in parking lots, so they have movable furniture, but they have also their parking spaces, and so there are corridors, and you can still walk around, and there's a little bit of an order in this case. So we introduced this idea that we have parking lots where the desk can move in different constellations, and we created walls you can move around, because when they, for example, they work for Audi, they want to dive into the Audi world and they need a lot of pictures around them, so they need walls, they cannot just break down the walls. And so we created that space, left and right is all mobile, but in the center, that was really important for them. It's like kind of hot desking, but they really wanted to have like a heart in the office where the teams can meet, because you always change your team, but in the end the discipline, you lose the contact, for example, for the creative discipline or the technical discipline, and they created there in the center their own home, their home base. So it looks like you see here on the pictures, moving tables and the parking lots and moving walls. And here's some details. So everybody has a personal drawer and a personal cabinet, but that's it. Everything else is like for everybody. And here you have a look in one of the that's the creative home base. And that's the entrance, and here also it was quite important for the owner to have a big table, like you have it again back home in the kitchen, where he can sit, where the clients can sit, where guests can sit, so to really get his family feeling. And this was now in the digital world, SAP and Razorfish, but we also have clients from, this is an, they supply gas and supply water, and they come out of a world, it was state-owned, so you have this really, these people, they are like 30 years in the same company, and on the other side you have quite young people, and when we had a workshop they crashed together, because they have different ideas of how the office should look like, so we had quite a fight in the workshop. But then the building looks like a star. And we decided, even though they all have different office areas, like single offices, double offices, and open space, it should always look the same. There has to be a red line going through the office. And especially here in the center, this area, they should be able to meet and to exchange, so the teams still stay in contact. And that's now a view into the entrance area. And that's the heart where they can meet. And we had long discussions, how does it work? How can we bring the people into the center? And we decided to just have there the coffee machine, so they are attracted to go there and have their coffee there. And as simple as it is, it worked out. They go there. And these are some meeting rooms. Curtains are always great because you can change the level of discretion. You can close it and open it up. And that's an area of the IT department. And we also have single offices. And the last one is a daughter or a sister company to the HSE. They do all the piping for the supplies. And as you might know it, they came out of a standard office and they moved into a huge building. It was, the ceiling height was 5.6 meter, and we were thinking how to bring this down to a human level, and we thought of bringing in this yellow ceiling, yellow because all the gas pipes in Germany are yellow, so we brought the link and we created, this is a rendering, a space, so you have the 3 meters to the yellow ceiling and you feel much more comfortable than sitting under 5.6 meters. And we also play with informal meeting spaces in variations like stand-up and sofas, etc. Plants are really important. And also we work together with some graphic companies, as you see in the background, the yellow circle. So that spices up the office. That's the end.
Well, I hope that happens in the bottom. I have some question maybe. Ah, come here, come on. That's the source of the answer, so.
I have a question maybe to start things on. I think it's a good opportunity for you to ask questions because you know so many things about big clients and it's interesting. Thank you very much, Virgil. It was interesting. I just wanted to comment with you a little bit on a slide that you had regarding the balance between efficiency and job motivation. And in this new type of working environment, the efficiency is not so big, but the motivation is not much higher. How can you explain this to clients? Of course, they would say, okay, I would like to invest. I would like to have motivated workers, but how about the efficiency?
You mean efficiency in terms of space or in terms of?
In terms of, I think it was referred to efficiency in terms of work. doing the job. Yeah.
It's the same. If you have motivated people, I think, it's the best to have because then you become also efficient. If you have an environment which really fits to your organization, where you can fast exchange ideas, where you can have enough meeting spaces, this is much more efficient than always sending emails and trying to find the right person. So it's not contradictory, it goes together. It also shows the study of Fraunhofer Institute that motivated people are also better performing people, so in fact it's what you told us before. So you need to motivate.
So it's not a trade-off.
Otherwise you're not stuck.
Aveți vreo întrebări? So there are no more questions. Thank you again.
Thank you.
Draga Mihai, is not the only one.